good morning, good morning. God bless each and every one of you. Amen. Under the sound of my voice. Amen. Glory to God. Welcome to this, our daily devotion. Amen. We want to thank God, amen, for this day that he has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. Amen. Glory be to God. Amen. The other day, amen, I brought a word, amen, about, amen, forgiveness, amen, and being, amen, glory be to God, doing the things that the Lord would have us to do, amen, getting away from gossip, sins of the spirit, different things of this nature. And I'll be doggone if I wasn't tried right afterwards, amen, glory be to God, and am still being tried today. Amen, glory be to God. My daughter, amen, is in a battle with a bully in her school, a young man, amen, who is threatening her. Amen, he has threatened her two or three times already. And then, amen, on that same day that I had spoken, amen, he had threatened to do me harm. She said that she was going to tell her father. And he said, tell him, I'll do him too. Amen. It wasn't that nice. Amen. Glory be to God. But y'all know, amen, what he said. And so, amen, automatically, amen, the old author, amen, rose up. Amen. Glory be to God. And Lord have mercy. I said, well, we just going to have to go see this young man then. Amen. Glory be to God. We going to have to go, amen, and have a little talk. Amen. Glory be to God. And I was reminded right afterwards, remember what you just got through speaking. Now, look, I'm not trying to do him no harm. Lord have mercy, unless he give me no other choice. Amen, glory be to God. But God knows, amen, we're not going to have no bullies, amen, no young men threatening my daughter or otherwise. And amen, she left out of here today, went to school, amen, glory be to God, and he started in on her again. Amen, glory be to God. She said that the teacher told him to leave and that they were going to kick him out of the program and the whole nine yards. And I hope and pray that they stick to their guns, because this young man is just a loose cannon. Amen. So we're going to pray, amen, for my daughter. We're going to pray for that situation, that God would step in, amen, and deliver her, glory be to God, out of the mouths of the lion. Amen. Glory be to God. He's whooping and hollering about her. Amen. They showing favoritism to her and different things of this nature. Well, you know, that happens when you're doing what is right. Amen. Glory be to God. God gives you favor. Hello, somebody. Amen. Glory be to God. And my daughter, amen, has favor because she's doing what is right. People trust her, amen, know that they can depend on her, amen, glory be to God. They have, amen, so, I mean, so to the point, giving her a job at the college, amen, glory be to God. She had the keys, amen, glory be to God. I'm telling you, checking their mail and all this other kind of stuff, amen, glory be to God. That's what the Lord does, amen, when you're doing what's right. And there's always going to be somebody, amen, hating on you because, amen, glory be to God, you're walking in an excellent spirit. Hello, somebody. Amen, glory be to God. I don't know what folks are thinking about, amen, but we teach our children, amen, glory be to God, to do what is absolutely right. Even if you ain't born again, even if you're not, amen, made a choice to serve the Lord, amen, glory be to God, do what is right. Amen. Glory be to God. Do what is right. Hallelujah. So, amen. Glory be to God. We're going to pray about that in just a little bit. But I do want to welcome everybody, amen, to this broadcast on the phone lines, in the chat room, amen. Those listening, amen, from Facebook, MySpace, LinkedIn, Twitter, Google+, amen, wherever you are, we want to thank God for you, amen, being here with us on today. Hear this. Amen. We'll be right back.
Hello, Jesus, Jesus, children, Jesus loves you, Jesus, children, hello, children, Jesus loves you of America. Are you hearing what he's saying? Are you feeling what you're praying? Are you healing pain? What you say inside? Yeah.
God, I thank you for this day that you've made. I honor you, Lord God, for all that you've done, all that you're doing, and all that you're yet going to do. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ, we lift up every individual around this world, Lord God, that's being bullied, where they're being intimidated, Lord God, where they're being tried beyond compare. Father, I pray that you intervene on their behalf in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Send your holy angels. Give them to do battle, Lord God, and give them to prevail in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Abba, yana, siri, so, kianda, ba, ma, masaya, gada, na, 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 si, ke, he, gada, masaya, go, ya, ba, shika, go, ya, ma, ma, mosa, go, ya, ma, ma, mosika, ye, gada, na, yeso, go, ya, na, na, no, soya, hey, gada, na, yesika, hey, gada, na, na, si, hey, God, thank you. Give them to prevail. Give them to prevail in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Glory, 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 glory to God. Move, Lord God, right now on the behalf of your people everywhere in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Glory to God. We thank you and we bless you right now in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Be in your word on today. Give us, Lord God, exactly what you would have us to know in the precious name of Jesus Christ. We give you all the praise, all the honor, and all the glory that you so richly deserve. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Glory to God. Amen. Hallelujah. And amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Now I know you're tired, but come on. Put your hands together. I know you're tired, but come on. Put your hands together. Oh, come on. I know you're tired, but put your hands together. Come on. Jesus, I'll never forget. Look at somebody and say, I'll never forget. I'll never forget. Come on, clap your hands. Come on. I know you love him. Act like the devil's head is in between your hands and clap him.
Come on,
Jesus,
I'll never forget.
Come on, sing it.
Come on,
Jesus,
I'll never forget.
Come on,
sing it.
Come on,
sing it.
Come on, sing it. Somebody shout never! Never!
Jesus, I'll never forget what you've done for me. Amen. Glory be to God. Welcome, welcome, welcome each and every one of you. Amen. Glory be to God. Amen to this, our daily devotion. Amen. We're coming out of 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 15 through 20. Amen. Glory be to God. We're going to share a few verses of scripture. Amen. Glory be to God. But, amen, I think that this is imperative. Amen. I woke up this morning, amen, asking God what he would have me to do. Because God knows, amen, glory be to God, if he doesn't give me a word, I'm not going to speak. Amen, glory be to God. And if I can't find anybody, amen, to share a word, amen, glory be to God, I won't have a broadcast. Amen, glory be to God. But 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 15 through 20. Amen, glory to God. The Bible says, know ye not that your bodies are the members of Christ? Shall I then take the members of Christ and make them members of an harlot? God forbid. Of course not. What? Know ye not that he which is joined to a harlot is one body? For two, saith he, shall be one flesh. I know that, amen, glory be to God, a lot of people, amen, teach that this has to do with marriage. In this instance, he's not talking about marriage. He's talking about, amen, unions, agreements, amen, fellowships, different things of this nature. We have to be careful of our associations. Amen, glory be to God. We have to be very, very careful, amen, who we allow ourselves, amen, to conduct business with, amen, glory be to God, who we go into business with. And we're going to, amen, go into 2 Corinthians chapter 6 also, amen, glory be to God, where he told us to be not unequally yoked together with unbelievers. Amen, glory be to God. Verse 17 says, but he that is joined unto the Lord is one spirit. Amen, glory be to God. He that is joined unto the Lord, he that is in agreement with the Lord, he that has made, amen, a decision, amen, to be in league with the Lord is one spirit. So then when we do that with, amen, people that are unsaved, we become one with them. Amen, glory be to God. Verse 18 says, flee fornication. Amen, glory be to God. Flee fornication. Every sin that a man doeth is outside of the body, without the body. But he that committeth fornication sinneth against his own body. He sins against his own body. Having sexual intercourse before you're married, you're sinning against your own body. Amen. Glory be to God. What? Know ye not that your body is the temple of the Holy Ghost, which is in you, which ye have of God, and ye are not your own? Your body, there's a lot of people that are preaching today and talking, this is my body, I do with it as I please. No, it's not your body either. It's been purchased. Whether you're saved or unsaved, your body has been purchased. Jesus died for the sins of the whole world. He didn't die just for the people, amen, that receive him. He died for the sins of the whole world. None of us belong to ourselves. This is not your body, and you do not have the right to do with it as you please. That's the word. For ye are bought with a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's, which both belong to God. Now, in 2 Corinthians chapter 6, verses 14 through 18, I'm going to tie this up in a minute. He tells us to be ye not unequally yoked together with unbelievers. For what fellowship have righteousness with unrighteousness, and what communion have light with darkness? Well, amen, glory be to God. Every last one of us know that the two don't mix. But when he tells you, amen, he's giving you, amen, the idea of a donkey and an oxen yoked together. Now, that you talking about unequally yoked. That's unequally yoked for real. As a man, glory be to God, Prophet Scott would say, for real, that's unequally yoked. Seriously. See, in bread and an oxen, in their DNA, I believe, amen, is the idea that they can do anything. That no matter how hard or how heavy the burden, they keep pushing, they keep pulling, they keep doing, amen, until they succeed. They buckle down, amen, glory be to God. They will keep on trying until they succeed. Whereas a donkey is designed to carry burdens also, but a donkey is only going to carry so much. They're stubborn. They're lazy. Amen. Glory be to God. And when that burden gets too heavy, they'll sit down on you and will stubbornly fight against you while you're trying to pull them to get up and get something done. Be ye not unequally yoked together with unbelievers. If I, amen, glory be to God, if I'm an oxen, I need another oxen on the side of me. I don't need a donkey. Hello, somebody that's going to sit down on me. Amen, glory be to God, when things get rough, when things, amen, get a little too heavy, I need somebody, amen, that's going to, amen, buckle down right along with me and keep on a pushing. There are those, amen, that will teach you this has got to do with marriage. No, it don't. It's got to do with any relationship, any union, any business association, whatever the case may be. The Bible tells us, for what fellowship have righteousness with unrighteousness? We're talking about unbelievers. We're talking about unbelievers. What communion have light with darkness? And what concord have Christ with Belial? Oh my God. Or what part has he that believeth with an infidel? That's another word for unbeliever. And what agreement have the temple of God with idols? Come on here, somebody. Good God Almighty. That shoots one religion down. For ye, you are the temple of the living God. You are. As God has said, I will dwell in them and walk in them, and I will be their God, and they shall be my people. Wherefore, come out from among them, and be ye separate, saith the Lord, and touch not the unclean thing, and I will receive you. My God, from Zion, Lord, help us to discern. Lord God, those right relationships helps us to discern. Lord God, all of the raunchy, all of the sand ballots, Lord, all the secret enemies, Lord, every individual that the enemy is trying to infiltrate us with, give us discernment. Give us to understand. The Bible says in verse 18, and will be a father unto you, and ye shall be my sons and daughters, saith the Lord Almighty. Now, why is this necessary? Why is all of this necessary? Because there are some relationships that are hard for us to break. We have to make a decision. Am I going to live for God, or am I going to live for myself? Ephesians. Amen. Glory be to God. 6. Glory to God. Verses 10 through 20. That Bible says, finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil, the schemes, the plots, the little plans of the devil. He's always plotting, y'all. Whenever get it in your mind, amen, glory be to God, that Lord, I just need a break. I just need a break from all this. You ain't going to never have no break until, amen, Jesus calls you home. You're not going to have no break. That devil ain't playing with you, and he ain't playing with me. He playing for keeps. He wants to destroy our souls. And amen, glory be to God, we've got to be strong in the Lord. We've got to be strong in the Lord. We've got to be strong in him, amen, in defending our souls, our hearts, and our minds, our ministries, our families, our everything. We've got to be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. That means, amen, glory be to God, that there's certain things that have to be settled within us. I'm living for God and nothing else. I'm going to do his will and nothing else. Glory, my God from Zion. Thank you, Jesus. So he tells us, amen, glory be to God, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood. My enemy is not man. My daughter's enemy is not that boy who's trying to threaten her and bully her in her school. That foul, that jealous demon, amen, glory be to God, upset because, amen, God has given my daughter favor. He's not the enemy. It's a spirit that's driving him. Amen, glory be to God. Abba, glory to God. We bind that demon. We bind that spirit in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We don't wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Listen, when we going to start warring with the adversary? When we going to start falling out with people? Amen, glory be to God, and taking the fight to the real enemy. Hello, somebody. When we, amen, glory be to God, going to start telling the devil off like we tell one another off? When we going to start putting him in his place like we put each other in our place? Come on here, somebody. Talk to me up in here. When we, amen, glory be to God, go take the real fight to the real enemy. Glory be to God. That's the devil himself. Shabaliasi. Give the most shot. Tired of him. Bible said, therefore, he said, wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, not pieces and parts, but the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day. And having done all, to stand. Stand, therefore. Having done everything that you're supposed to do in order to stand. Stand, therefore. Having your loins girt about with truth. And having on the breastplate of righteousness. Glory to God. And your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. See, it's your faith. It's your faith. Let me tell you something. Without faith, Satan can do anything he wants to with you. It's your faith that quenches or puts out the fire all his little darts, all his little schemes, all his little plans, all his little plots. It's your faith that overcomes him. So when he attacks your faith. He's not, amen, glory be to God, he's not concerned about you because your name is such and such. He's concerned about you because of, amen, glory be to God, your faith. You trust God. Hello, somebody. You trust God because you believe God. He's after you because of your proclamation, because of your confession, because of what you stand for, because you dare open your mouth and regurgitate the scriptures. Amen. Glory be to God. He's after your faith. He don't care nothing about your title. He don't care nothing about your calling. He don't care nothing about what church you go to. He's concerned about your faith. Your faith is a shield, and it protects you. Hello, somebody. Abba, glory to God. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God. Praying always with all prayer and supplications in the Spirit, watching thereto with all perseverance and supplications for all saints. You understand what that's saying? He's saying stay on your post. Stay on your post. Don't you stop praying. He said keep on a watching over your brethren and keep on a praying. Don't ever, amen, glory be to God, stop just because things are going good. See, that's when the adversary catches us. That's when he messes us up. Because then we drop our guard. We go to sleep thinking everything is okay. Or he answered that prayer. Amen, glory be to God. We rejoice and we praising God. The devil's sitting over there, amen, while you rejoicing and praising God. He's over there plotting. He's trying to figure out how he's going to take away from you what you just got. Amen. Glory be to God. And we drop our guard. Don't drop your guard. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the spirit. Where? In the spirit. That's a capital S right there, y'all. That's a capital S. It's referring to the Holy Ghost, and it's referring to the word of the Lord. Amen. Glory be to God. You can't do wrong when you're praying what the word of the Lord says. He cannot, amen, stop the word of God. He can't do anything with it. Your opinion, he'll stump all over you. Your feelings, your thoughts on the matter, he will stump all over you. But when you stand, amen, firm on what is written, as our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ did when he was, amen, tempted of the devil. He said, it is written. That's how he overcome the adversary. It is written. He cannot fight the word. He can't refute it. He can't do anything with it. Nobody can, to be real honest with you. So now you find, amen, glory be to God, in our world today, where people will try, they will try to disregard the word of God altogether. As if you didn't say nothing at all. You ain't going to stop me from saying it, though. You ain't going to stop me from speaking it. Verse number 19, and for me, that utterance may be given unto me, that I may open my mouth boldly, boldly, to make known the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in bonds, that therein I may speak boldly as I ought to speak. And I speak this to every preacher, every leader, every minister of the gospel. Amen. Glory be to God. I pray that that door of utterance be opened unto you, that you may open your mouth boldly and, amen, make known the mystery of the gospel. Hey! Sha! Yirando! Rabba! Chienda su! Roshoya! Yeah, but God! Thank you. Glory to God. Yay. Glory to God. That door of utterance be open. Yay. Glory. Hallelujah. Revelation 21, verse 7 and 8. Let me tell y'all. Some separations, amen, are very, very painful. Very painful. But I'm going to tell you something. When you're in a relationship that causes you to scheme, it causes you, amen, glory be to God, to, amen, glory be to God, plot and plan and, amen, play games. First of all, that individual is not in Christ, nor is the individual that they're dealing with. But, amen, glory be to God, behind closed doors, people are making plans and doing things they got no business doing, sneaking, amen, skinning and grinning and all this other kind. That's not of God. That's not of God. People, amen, going around trying to find fault in your life, trying to find, amen, something to say concerning you, amen, to destroy or discredit you. Let me tell you something. That's not God. I know, amen, the Bible tells us that there are some that kill you that think that they do God's service. They think they're doing, there's some folks out here that actually got the nerve to say that God raised them to expose pastors and preachers that are not walking upright before God. What? Let me see. What office is that? What ministry is that? Since when is God, amen, raising up people, amen, to go around specifically to find fault with folk and expose them? What spirit is that? Because it sure ain't Christ. And if that's what you think, amen, glory be to God. If anybody think, please do me a favor, get out of my life. With the quickness, get out of, if that's the type of individual you are, amen, glory be, please get out of my life. Please. And I mean that. Lord, that ain't no calling. That's a great deception. That's a great deception. The Bible says in Revelation 21, verse 7 and 8, he said, he that overcometh shall inherit all things. Overcometh. The individual, amen, glory be to God, that overcomes every obstacle, every situation and circumstance that arises in their lives and remains unscathed, remains obedient to the will and to the word of God, shall inherit all things. Hello, somebody. Amen. Glory be to God. Glory be to God. My wife will tell you, I'll walk away from a family member in a heartbeat. I don't care who you are. If you ain't right and you ain't trying to get right, you got to get away from me. And amen, glory be to God. Especially if you're trying to infiltrate my family, trying to infiltrate my home and bring in dissension, the devil is a liar. You got to go. I don't care who you are. You got to go. Y'all better hear me. Amen, glory be to God. She on the line. She can attest. I walk away from the, I don't care who you are, I'm telling you. When it comes down to serving God, amen, I mean business every step of the way. I mean to see Jesus in peace. Now, my Bible tells me if your left eye offends you, amen, glory be to God, or your right eye, whichever one you choose, amen, if it offends you, pluck it out. It's better for you to enter into life halt and maimed than for both you and your eyeball, amen, to be cast into hell. I'm not going to hell for nobody, for no friendship, for no fellowship. You hear what I say? I mean what I say. He that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. But the fearful and unbelieving and the abominable and murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire and brimstone, which is the second death. Oh, my. Lastly, Revelations 22, verses 14 and 15. Blessed are they that do his commandments, that they may have right to the tree of life, and may enter in through the gates into the city. For without, outside, are dogs and sorcerers and whoremongers and murderers and idolaters and whosoever loveth and maketh a lie. Nobody who does these things is going to enter in the kingdom of heaven. Nobody. Nobody. Amen. Glory be to God. We, amen, have got, amen, glory be to God, to stay right with God. Hello, somebody. We've got to stay right with God. Hallelujah. Amen. Glory be to God. Amen. I want to welcome everybody. Amen. Glory be to God who's here. Amen. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. My God, my God, my God. I'm just going back, amen, looking at some of the things, amen, glory be to God, that the amen has been typed in, amen, glory be to God. I'm telling you, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Father. There's a question in there. Outside is where for me? Are you referring to the verse I just spoke on? Keelin? Or Quailin. Amen. Glory be to God. Outside of the will of God, outside of the kingdom. Amen. Glory be to God. If, amen, we go back over that scripture, over that verse of scripture. Hold on 1 second. Let me pull it back up. Thank you, Jesus. We're talking about people. Amen, glory be to God, who have not made the decision to serve the Lord. Amen, glory be to God, and are not in the kingdom of heaven. They're not with the Lord. Outside of those, amen, glory be to God, that have been condemned. We're talking about, amen, Revelations 22, 14 and 15. Blessed are they that do his commandments, that they may have right to the tree of life and may enter in through the gates into the city. So then, if, amen, that be the case, those that do his commandments, then those outside of those who didn't do his commandments. Amen. Glory be to God. Say, amen. We are definitely, oh my. Okay, let me close that out. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Quailin. Okay. All right. Oh, and anyways, Amen. We thank God, amen, for all of you, amen, being here with me. Amen. Glory be to God on this day. We bless, amen, the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. Thank God for his word. Amen. Glory be to God. And I'm telling you, amen, it is the only thing, amen, that will sustain us and take us all the way through. Being obedient, amen, to his word brings about blessing, gives us peace. Amen. Glory be to God. I'm telling you, I just love him and I appreciate him. Amen. Glory be to God. Be careful, brethren. Be careful. Amen. These associations, amen, these relationships, amen, we got to be very careful. Even now, over on Facebook and so many other places, amen, I'm being led, amen, to prune, amen, because there's a lot of cursing going on. There are people, amen, who are supposed to be calling on the name of the Lord. One minute, and I read, amen, glory be to God, I read, amen, amen, bless you, Quee Lynn, amen, God bless you, amen. I read a post, amen, from a cousin of mine who was cussing up a storm and then turned right around in the same breath, in the same one, and said that they need Jesus. They need to repent. I'm going to pray for them. I was like, oh, my God. Oh, my God. How can we carry on like this and think that we're okay? How is it that we believe that it's all right for a Christian to curse, to drink, to party, to do the same things that we were doing when we were in the world? How is that possible? What kind of deception is that? God have mercy. Even I know, with my uneducated self, even I know that that's fallacy, that that's foolishness. Why, amen, glory be to God, would I want to remain in the same thing that I was crying to God to be delivered from after I come to Christ? Why would I want to remain in that? The devil is a liar. No. I don't want to stay in my sin. Jesus died to remove that from our lives, to free us from that bondage, and to give us a brand new life. A better life, the best life that we can have. Glory to God. He died on that cross. Hallelujah. Shed his precious blood. Glory to God. This man who knew no sin became sin for every last one of us. Like I say, he died for the sins of the whole world. Not just certain of us, but for everybody. That's the reason why we've got to get out there and tell them. We got to tell them. Hello, somebody. We got to tell them. We've got to let people know. We've got to let people know. Got to help them. Amen. Glory be to God. We really do. We really do. My God, my God. Oh my, yeah, I saw that video, Prophetess, and I saw something concerning amen, the donkey, bring your donkey to church. Amen, glory be to God. That there are things, amen, that people, amen, glory be to God, are saying and doing, and it's causing, amen, confusion. It's causing confusion. Amen, glory be to God. It's fascinating. It's fascinating what's happening, amen, in the body today. But we've got to stay on our post. And saints of God, let me encourage you, amen. If you're not one who consecrates yourself unto the Lord, start. Start doing it. Amen. We really need to consecrate, amen, and destroy this flesh that we live in. Destroy its influence. Destroy its ability, amen, to step up whenever it gets ready. Amen. Glory be to God. You know, when we're a little out of shape, we get a little flabby. Amen. We go to the gym and we work out. Amen. And we tighten up on whatever it is, amen, we got a problem with. And we do what we have to do to maintain that. It's no different, amen, glory be to God, for our spirit man. We need to do the things that are necessary to build our spirit man up and decay the influence and power of our flesh. Amen. Glory be to God. We need to do that. We need to do that. Amen. Glory be to God. I thank God, amen, for each and every last one of you, amen, being here with me again on today. Amen. Yesterday, amen, I got several phone calls, amen, and people, amen, needing prayer. One sister, amen, was talking about, amen, she had been in so much pain for the last few days, amen, with her mouth, amen, glory be to God, and her head, amen, so painful she couldn't sleep at night. Amen. Glory be to God. It kept her up. And amen. Thank you, Jesus. She called me and amen, asked me to pray with her. Amen. Glory be to God. And we prayed, and I told her that I would check with her in the morning and see how she did. I texted her and asked her if everything was all right. I pray that you slept well. She said, I slept like a baby. And she said, thank you for your prayers. Amen. Glory be to God. We, amen, want to be effective, amen, in every aspect of our lives. We need to humble ourselves, amen, glory be to God, and follow the leading of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. I want him to make me. I don't want to make myself, amen, glory be to God. I don't. I want him to make me, amen, glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. I want him to make me. Please, Lord. Make me what you would have me to be. Make me to be the man of God you've chosen for me to be. I want to fit the mold you made for me. I don't want to be the type of person, Lord, that demands to be a certain way, to do certain things. I only want to do what you have designed for me to do. Those things, Lord, that I'm anointed to do. I don't want to walk in another man's office. I don't want to do another man's work. I want to do what you called me to do. And Father, when I'm done, when I've completed my task, take me home and let me rest with you. I pray this, Lord God, for your children everywhere. Father, that you would revive us, that you would make us over again another. And Father, you would repair us where we've been broken, where we've been cracked, where we've been misused and abused. Lord, we've been chipped, we've been dented. Father, I pray you in the name of the Lord Jesus, fix us. Fix us, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, that we may be used by you to bring others into your kingdom. Open up that door of utterance to each and every last one of us. Give us holy boldness that we may speak your word. No matter the environment, no matter the hostilities around us, that, Father, we would not be intimidated, but rather increased in strength. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, strengthen our feet and our legs, our bodies all together. Renew, Lord God, each and every last one of us right now. Renew our minds, renew our spirits, renew our hearts. Help us, Lord. Help us. Glory to God. To finish what you started. In the precious name of Jesus Christ. Oh, God, we thank you. We thank you. Glory to God. We thank you. We bless you. In Jesus' perfect and precious name. Amen. Glory to God. My. Glory to God. Father God, we pray right now even for your people who are going through battles in their minds and in their hearts, in their very souls. Satan, the Lord rebuke you. I bind all of your foulness, all of your lies. I come against you in the name of the Lord Jesus. Glory to God. All your entrapments, all your mess. Glory to God. We evict you. Hey, Abasha, we evict you. Hey, you're messing with God's property. You're trespassing. Leave in the most high name of Jesus. Glory to God. Glory to God. Right now. Right now. Glory to God. Let's praise him. Let's glorify his holy name. Glory to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. My God, my God, my God. Thank you, Father. Let's praise, amen, our way out of that. Amen, glory be to God. Praise, amen, glory be to God. Give him honor and give him glory. Lift up his holy and wonderful name. Glory be to God. For that enemy is already defeated. No need to fight. Just praise God for the victory. I thank you, Lord. I glorify you and I bless you for all of these, your people. Bless them in a special way. In the name of Jesus Christ, we thank you. Glory to God. My. Father God, in the precious name of Jesus Christ, oh, we pray, Lord God, right now for that heartbeat, even as our sister has asked, Lord God, for prayer, in the name of Jesus Christ. I command you, heal this soul, heal the Nisi, Robo Shandai, Kuyama Sindi, Radia Sika, heal the Mamosa, heal the soul of Mama, heal the soul, I am a Mamosa, take your hands off. It is so. Your God, I thank you. Now, glory to God, you better back up, devil. You better back up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, 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 glory, hallelujah, glory, hallelujah, glory, hallelujah. I glorify your holy and wonderful name. I thank you, Lord. I thank you. I thank you. Glory. I thank you. Hallelujah. God, I thank you. God, I thank you. God, I thank you. Glory to God, I thank you. Glory to God, I thank you. Hallelujah. God, I thank you. Glory to God, I thank you. Hallelujah. Glory. Hallelujah. Oh, I praise you for the healings. I praise you for deliverance. I praise you right now, God, in the name of the Lord Jesus. I praise you. I praise you. Glorify you. Hallelujah. Quilin, I was speaking in tongues for most of that. Amen. Glory be to God. No one could tell you what I said unless God gave them the interpretation. Amen. Glory to God. I was speaking in the Holy Ghost. That's a heavenly language. Amen. Glory be to God. Thank the Lord, amen, for all of his goodness and all of his blessings. Thank him. Glory be to God for the victories he has bestowed upon us. Listen, don't take the enemy's mess. Pray against him. Jesus has given us power to tread on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy. Nothing by any means shall hurt you. All the power of the enemy entails all of his plots and schemes and all of his sickness and all of his disease. He's given us power. Dunamis. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen, amen. Bless his holy name. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Amen. Bless each and every last one of you. I appreciate you so much. Amen, for being here with me on today. If there are no other prayer requests, amen, glory be to God. Amen. I just thank you. And I pray that the rest of your day be ever, ever, ever so blessed. Amen. Glory be to God. Y'all know I love to pray. I love to pray. Amen. Glory to God. Let me take this call. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Area code 662, you're on the air.
Hello. I would like prayer for my job.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. I got you, Quilin. I got you. Amen. Glory to God. I got you. Amen. Yes, yes, we want to pray. Amen. Father, in the precious name of Jesus Christ, I lift up your handmaiden before you, Lord. And we pray, Lord God, concerning this job. You know exactly what must need be done, Father. You know everything, glory to God, nothing is hid from you. She needs direction, Lord God, which way to go. What is it, Lord God, that you have designed for her life? Now, I pray, Lord God, that all confusion, amen, glory be to God, and every foul and unclean spirit that would come and try to halt her blessing, every demon that will try to keep the answer from reaching her soul, I pray in the name of Jesus that they be removed. Lord God, that you would expound to her, Lord God, ever, ever so profoundly what your will is for her life in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. But in the meanwhile, we bind every foul and unclean spirit on that job. Hey, glory be to God. Every lazy demon, every spirit, Lord God, that fights against her in the name of the Lord Jesus. Glory to God. We come. Oh, my God. We come. Oh, we call it null and void right now in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Dispatch your holy angels in that place, Lord, in the name of Jesus. And let their very presence be a rebuke unto the devil in the precious name of Jesus Christ. We thank you and we bless you for this right now. Make it plain, Father. Make it plain. In Jesus' precious name we pray. Thank you, Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. And amen. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. God bless you. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Glory to God. Quilin, you're asking, amen, for prayer. Amen. Is that to me? Okay. Yeah, yeah. Okay. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Amen. 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 All right. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, we lift up Quilin. You know who they are, Lord God. And Father, in the precious name of Jesus Christ, you see, Lord God, the prayer quest. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, I want, now, I'm breaking through this prayer for a minute. Are you male or female, Quilin? I want to say you're female. Thank you, Jesus. I want to say you can. Can you just right quick, please let me know. I don't, amen, okay. I felt, okay, all right. Father, we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, amen, that she would, amen, overcome in every last one of her studies, in everything, glory be to God, that she puts her hands to, that you would bless in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, glory be to God, that you would give her, Lord God, that confidence and give her, Lord God, right now, that conclusion within herself, that everything that she does, Lord God, she will succeed in the name of the Lord Jesus. We thank you, glory, we thank you. Give her favor in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Glory, hallelujah. Give her uncommon knowledge. Give her uncommon understanding in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. We thank you. We bless you for it right now in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Glory to God. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. All right, Hong Kong. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. All right. Bless his holy and wonderful name. Amen. Are there any other? You're so welcome. You are so welcome. Amen. Glory to God. Bless you. Amen. Are there any other prayer requests? Amen. Before we, amen, get ready to go. Thank you, Jesus. We'll let you get on with the rest of your day. I do so appreciate each and every last one of you. Amen. Glory be to God. Yes, Lord. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. I thought Prophetess was trying to say something there. Amen. God bless you. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. We're going to continue to pray. Even as the word of God has commanded us to do so, we're going to continue to pray. Amen. And to trust God for one another. We're going to continue to stand in the gap for one another. Hello, somebody. Amen. To believe God for one another. Whatever it is that you need, I stand in agreement. Whatever it is you need God to do for you, I stand in agreement. I praise his holy and wonderful name. Amen. Glory be to God for everything that he's done, everything that he's doing, and everything that he's yet going to do. Amen. Amen. God bless each and every last one of you. Amen. Indeed is my prayer. Have a blessed and wonderful day. Oh, amen, amen. Glory to God. I'm already on that. I'm already on that. Amen. Trust me, I'm already on that. Amen. Glory be to God. And we're asking God, amen, to pour out, amen, blessings that we will not have room enough to receive it. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. You as well, Cheryl Munford. Amen. Glory to God. Bless the Lord. Each and every last one of you be ever so blessed. Amen. Is indeed our prayer as always. Glory to God. Keep us in your prayers. And amen. If the Lord say the same, we'll be back here again on tomorrow. Till next time. Bye-bye.
You have just heard another powerful message from the Lord. If you would like to write our pastor, you can do so by sending all correspondence to P.O. Box 777, Clarksdale, Mississippi 38614. For gifts of support, you can make them out to Powerhouse Ministry or go to our website and click the donation button at www.powerhouseministryinc.org. God bless you and keep you in our prayer.